We're going to read question five, which is as follows. The exponential graph of h of x is equal to half times 2 to the power x minus 1 is given. Write down the equation of the asymptote of h worth 1 mark. Calculate the x-intercept of h worth 2 marks and calculate the y-intercept of h also worth 2 marks. Sketch the graph of h on a system of axes. Clearly show all intercepts with the axes and asymptotes with 3 marks. And lastly, write down the equation of the graph formed if g is reflected over the asymptote with 2 marks. So the entire question is worth 10 marks. So this is what you need to do before you start attempting a question. Get an idea of what the expectation is. Then once you understand the expectation, you'll go back to the basics and say, what do I know about this topic? Let alone what I'm given, but what do I know? I know that the general equation of a exponential graph is given by y of x is equal to a times b to the power x minus q, sorry, plus q this one, plus q. So that is the general one. So in relation to the one I'm given, I know that, where's my pointer? I know that was to 2 and q is equal to minus 1. And what are these? And how do they influence this particular equation? So when a is more than 0, which means a is positive, it means that the function of the graph is going to lie above the asymptote. And if a is negative or below 0, it's going to lie below the asymptote. And then if b is greater than 1, it means we have an increasing function. And if b lies between 0 and 1, it means we have a decreasing function. And if q is positive, it means that our graph is shifted a couple of units upwards. And also means that if q is negative, it's shifted a couple of units downwards. This is with reference to the original exponential equation. So this is shifted equation of asymptote. So we can then now, with that understanding, try to respond to the questions. So the first one wants the equation of the asymptote, which is given by y is equal to negative 1, which is that. Requires us to calculate the x-intercept, so 5.2.1, right, to let y equal to 0 times 2 to the power x minus 1 is equal to 0. Get rid of that fraction, so we have 2 to the power x minus 2 to the power x equals 2. This is the same, we equate the exponent. Our x is equal to 1, not 0. 1, and the coordinates here are 4 marks. Then 5, determine or calculate the y-intercept. We let x is equal to minus 1 to the power 0 is 1 to half minus 1. Half minus 1 coordinates here is 0 and minus half. Then we are now required to sketch the graph at 5.3. We will need y-intercept, which is 1 and 0, and 0 and minus half. So that's what we're going to do. Is not. Okay, and the okay, y. Then down, this is minus 1, positive 1, 2, 3, negative 1. Need to make sure that your spacing is standard. Is well calibrated. The number 4, we need to do our asymptote, which is at that point. So we'll indicate that with the dotted line or dashed line. Then our x-intercept, which is where the graph is going to cross the x-intercept, is given by 1 and 0, which is at that point. And our y-intercept is at 0, 0 and minus half, which is at that point. And plot our function. It will move close but not to cross this one. Supposed to go over that dot, that point 1 and 0, and then you can label your coordinates, say minus half, one, then you should be in a position to score full marks on this question because it says you must show all intercepts which you've done. So a mark for X intercept, a mark for Y, and a mark for the asymptote. Then the last question says we need to write down the equation of the graph formed if G, so G is going to be our graph. So if G is reflected over the asymptote. So what does this mean? It means that you will have a graph that looks like this. So it will just be identical to that, but an opposite. Probably move somewhere there. Oh, this looks horrible. Oh, this looks horrible, but I hope you understand what we're trying to get to over here. We don't need a lot of lines, otherwise they cause a lot of confusion. Reflection means that the graph is just flipped. Yes, that does look better. So what is the equation if the graph looks like this? So first of all, what we can identify is that our asymptote rather remains the same. So the graph will be below the asymptote. So our g of x will still have minus one. And we know that if our graph is below, it means that our a is less than zero, which means we're going to have negative a. So it means then we're going to have 2 to the power x. That brings us to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you do, click the like button, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to see more tutorials on maths. Until next time, keep studying. Bye.